Welcome back, everyone, to Showbiz India. And today on our celebrity profile, it is indeed my pleasure to welcome the beautiful Amisha Patel once again to Los Angeles and to Showbiz India. It's always great to see you, and you look gorgeous.
Thank you. I'm having such a great time.
Now, you're just about to go for the India's Independence Day Mela. We're celebrating India's Independence Day, Yufika's as well. What has your experience been so far?
Well, I had earlier done the Independence Day parade in New York, and where they shut down Madison Avenue and you can actually do the whole Grand Marshal March there. And the experience has been really nice so far. I'm really proud to be an Indian, to see that India has a reach worldwide. And even though people have left for generations, no matter which part of the world they're in, especially in America, which is halfway across the world from India, they're still retaining their culture. They're still making the kids, you know, realize, imbibing them in the Indian values, and making them aware of the Indian freedom fighters and everything, which I think is very important and very easily forgotten.
Very well said, indeed. Now, I've had the pleasure of knowing you even when we were a couple of months ago in IFA in Toronto, and the fans were going crazy there as well. Last night, you attended a banquet, and I'm sure it was overwhelming to see the reaction of fans. So tell me in your words, how does a celebrity feel when you go through this?
Almost like an India-Pakistan war. Because you see everyone fighting for pictures, and last night I had to literally calm everyone down and say, look, we're here for Independence Day. You all better not fight amongst yourselves. But it feels good that you have such a great fan following, and people are, you know, bending over backwards to get just a glimpse of you or take a picture of you, because that is their lifelong memory. So of course it feels lovely. We don't realize it, how special it means, because you wake up and see yourself in the mirror every day and you're like, ah, there's nothing special about me. But of course for the fans it is, and I understand and adhere to their sentiments completely.
And this year I think has particularly been a milestone in that you've decided to have your own production company at such a young age. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
Now tell me about this production company.
Well, a friend of mine called Kunal was after me for about 3-4 years, because he's known me for 9-10 years now, and he's one of my closest friends. So he was like, you know, Amisha, you're too intelligent, too highly educated to just be wasting your life waiting for a phone call from some producer or director to sign you on, you know, a film. You need to be the boss of your own company. You need to be able to make the kind of cinema you would like to be part of as well. And the only way you can do that is if you open your own production. I completely did not believe in that at all. And I postponed, I don't know, I guess I was just very focused in, you know, I felt maybe it would be too much responsibility for me to shoulder, or I wouldn't be able to see it through. I don't know, I guess I was just not ready for it. Maybe there's a time and place for everything. And then last year again we started discussing it, and this time I decided to act upon it really seriously. That's why there's been a gap. I took a little bit of a break to set up the company, because I said if I have to do this seriously, then I have to give it my whole, and I can't be shooting in different parts of the world and not be focusing on the production. And Kunal and me spoke about it last Christmas, and April 23rd we launched our company called Amisha Patel Productions, and we've signed on two very, very good directors, the first one being David Dhawan, who I've worked with in a film called Yeh Hai Jalwa with Salman, and Priyadarshan, again, who I've worked with in Bhool Bhulaiya. So I'm really, really lucky that, you know, Kunal and me are partners in this production, and at the start we've got two brilliant directors, and we're not making small films, you know, we're making really huge films and very big budget A-grade films. So that is a lot of work, but I'm terribly excited about my new role in front of the camera as well as behind it.
Now, switching over gears, we're going to see you on screen very, very soon. You have a film releasing on
Friday. Yes, on the 19th of August.
With Sanjay Dutt?
Yes, it's called Chatur Singh Two Star, and I'm very, very excited about it, because it's the first time I'm going to do an actual comedy, full-fledged comedy film, where there's not another single girl in it except for me. And I'm surrounded by amazing actors like Shakti Kapoor and Gulshan Grover and Satish Kaushik and Anupam Kher, and, you know, there's a huge star cast, and Sanju, of course, is the title role of Chatur Singh, and he's done a brilliant job. He's this really goofy detective who thinks he's brilliant, really chatur, but he's a complete idiot and does all these, a lot of buffoonery and, you know, stupidity, and by default solves the case.
Okay.
So it's a complete comic caper. Leave your brains at home and come just enjoy yourself.
Any special anecdotes from this movie that you would share with us?
Well, I was really, really at first, when I used to be on the set, I used to feel overwhelmed because there were just so many men, from the makeup artists to all the star cast, and I was the only girl. But then they all started, treating me like one of the buddies, and it was really good fun. And I would actually burst out laughing in the middle of a scene because there were such hilarious moments that both Sanju and I would have to cut the shot and retake it because we were shooting Sing Sound and we couldn't afford for anything to go wrong. There are literally scenes where I've choked, spat out my Diet Coke, and then my directors retain that, as part of the comedy, because I saw Sanju one morning coming in this bizarre costume where he's wearing a blazer and trousers with shoes, and each sleeve is a different fabric and color and a print. Half of his jacket, front and back, are different. Each button is different. And his legs, each leg is different. Each shoe is different. And the scene was how he's explaining to me that, in case he has to go on this whole detective trip, if he shows his hand from one side, he looks like another person. If he shows the other side, he looks like another person. Like, every part of him should be able to be, a different human being. And I actually saw him approaching, and I was sipping my Diet Coke and I spat it out. So my director said, hey, that's good, retain it in the film. So there were many such moments that came very naturally because it was very, very hilarious.